Who's ready to play some more Shadowrun? I know I am. This has no real effect on your viewing experience, but I am now playing with a little gamepad. That's quite fun. It's a lot more fun than using the keyboard, in my opinion. We're going to try and clear out the rest of the arena now. See what we can do about that. This Decker is really a pain. Come on. Lock on. Ooh. Heals, heals. No. Let's try that again. We really just need the cash. There's a couple of items that would be really nice to pick up right now. Chase after him. Hit him. There we go. Wonder why that was so hard. Alright, 7,000 new yen. Oh, delicious. Love it, love it, love it. Let's go take a quick nap. And not pay 50 new yen for it. What's our karma at? 13. Might want to increase some things. Use karma attribute. Oh, now let's go to body 12. That's handy. We will save the game as well as save state. Having all these controls right here in one place is really quite nice. Got the save button on the trigger. The real advantage of this comes when I start doing MAME playthroughs. You know, like, stuff with Metal Slug. Oh, it's this mage. He replicates himself. And you can tell who the real one is because he's the one that throws powerballs at you. Sort of a kind of cup and ball thing. He's actually not too bad. So far. Really not actually hurting us at all. Come on. Take damage. Actually hitting the right guy? Maybe. Looks like it. Come on. You keep moonwalking all over the place. I'm onto your game. They should just die. Alright, fine. 5 karma. And 8,000 new yen. That is it. We have cleared out the arena. We have a grand total of 16,950 new yen. Oh, baby. I love it. Love it, love it, love it. Love everything about it. Pump our magic up to 7. Why don't we? Save. Okay, let's do some shopping. There's one item that we really, really want, and two others that we sort of want. And I'm not inclined to hold off on them until later. I'd rather just have them in my inventory, so I don't have to worry about them later. We're gonna go back to our good friend, the Talismonger. Pick up a little something-something. Some of that old black magic. Come on. Poking along. Alright, here we go. Now, the first thing we want is this. Yes, a steak. Want that. We also want you. No, actually not yet. Well, maybe. How much is these? 3,000? That's acceptable. We've left. 11,000? Well, you know what? Why the heck not? Let's just go on that way. And let's talk to you. Do I have the keyword I need for you? Ask about... No, I don't. I'll give you a call later. Lady. Yeah. Not in that way. We're not going to make a booty call to an old Indian shaman lady. I mean, what you do on your time is your own business. But that's not what this LP is about. Do-do-do. So casual about it. Oh, there, little assassins trying to put a bullet in my head. No big deal. Whatevs. Alright. Gonna hop a train. We're gonna go back downtown. We're gonna go see our good friend, the dog spirit. Huchiniqua. Gonna tell him that we, capped that rat shaman good. Because we did. Maybe we'll even get a reward out of it. Yeah. Go away. There we go. Ah. Bother. Button mashing. Do do do. Alright. Keep moving. Right out of the trees, man. It's this way. Right? Yep. More assassins. Give me your money. I apologize if I'm not providing any witty repartee right now. Not much to say right now, actually. I know that's why a lot of people watch LPs, but I try to provide some good commentary now and again, but I don't know, I'm kind of drawing a blank right now. Not much to make fun of, per se, or any interesting trivia. I will try to entertain you as best as I can. Making that money. Another mage. Alright. Your pimp suit is not bulletproof. Now let's use that little doohickey we just picked up from the talisman shop. Remember this giant octopus that tried to kill us? I sure do. Because it was pretty weird. It's full of black ink. What do we have? A black bottle. Now we have a bottle of ink. Because, you know, we like to practice calligraphy. Don't judge. I can never remember which one it is. It's this one. Alright. Now, talk to the dog.
You have done well. You have served Hushiniqua. You have cleaned the world of an enemy. Dog takes you as his own. From this time on, you travel with Hushiniqua at your side.
Oh, sweet. We just get initiated as a shaman?
Jake, you are in truth a shaman. Follow your calling. You know it has to be true. Technology has been thrust upon you. You are fated to use it to destroy your nemesis.
Well, that's pretty cool. Thanks, Dogman. Yes, he will guide us to our destiny. Tell me about the Jester Spirit.
A powerful enemy. He toys with you. He is a spirit of technology and decay. Find such a place, and you will have found his lair. Recite his true name, and you will have bound him to your will.
Cool. So, we have to find out his true name. And if we can find him in a place where technology is in decay, then we can bind him? That's great. Oh, and we now have the Powerball spell. To cast Freeze, you will need the residue of 2 sea creatures. Well, we have 1. Oh, I know where we need to go for that other bit. We can't get it yet. Don't recall. Now, we could be casting the Powerball spell at people, but it's kind of crap. The shotgun, quite frankly, does more damage than the spell right now, and we'd have to sink a whole bunch of XP into making it worthwhile, and even then, this gun doesn't run out of ammo. And we certainly run out of mana, so not entirely worth it. Now, let's go talk to Kitsune. She seems like a pretty smart lady. She probably knows what's going on. Maybe she can help us figure out what's going on with this Jester Spirit.
Could it be a nemesis? A sort of criminal mastermind? Puppeteering all of our actions? What wonderful existential crises we have to deal with.
This way, right? Stop it.
Go away. I shall taunt you a second time.
You'd think that killing these guys right in front of the security guards would give us a reason to get in for free. Yeah, we're kind of a big deal. Let me in. You know what? Wait, what? I must punish you for your lack of compassion. Minus one karma? The heck? Do not attack those who mean you no harm. Are you gonna keep docking me karma? You are. Wow, game, I didn't actually know that you had these repercussions. Wow. Maybe it's just those soulless corporate businessmen that you can kill without penalty. Come on, let me in. Alright. Let's have a quick chat with Kitsune. Come on, lady. Come back, fox girl. I want to ask you questions about mystic sorcery. Yes, we are cute. Vister Spirit. They say he's very powerful. From what I've heard, someone at the Darkblade knows where he haunts. Darkblade, eh? Vampires? Well, vampires is kind of par for the course at this point. I mean, we're talking to some kind of fox cat girl wizard pop star. Yes, I wouldn't trust vampires either. That is a good choice of advice. Yes, hello, Cecil. What can you tell me about the Dark Blades? No, you can't tell me anything. What about the Jester Spirit? Yes, we are better off asking a magic user. What about vampires? We get old times. We even had a vampire in here once. The Strobe sent him catatonic. Took us 15 real minutes to realize he wasn't doing some new dance craze. Seizure jokes. Oh, real classy game. Not funny. Like, for real, not funny. If you're gonna make a joke about seizures, don't. I will hit you. So there's some old strobe lights. So we've gotta go piss off some vampires with strobe lights, I guess. Is what this game is telling me. I'm okay with that, I guess. Because vampires. I'm not a fan of vampires. Yes, okay. People seem to know that Darkblade has something to do with vampires. Some kind of cult or mansion. What have you. Vampires. How about those strobes? Yes, we talked to Cecil. Suppose you can have them. Careful with your shine them, though they're a bit hard in the eyes. Yes, of course they are. Bring them back when you're finished. Yeah, that's not gonna happen. Or maybe it is. Do we actually have the strobe lights? Yes, we do. This is good. Now, one more thing. Use the cred stick to make a phone call. Will you accept charges? The Mystic Talisman Shop, Moon River speaking. I don't remember what voice I used for this lady. Yes, yes, yes. Do-do-do-do-do. Darkblade.
Their leader, he be evil. Do not allow yourself to fall victim to his lies. You best beware. Best you do not contact them in person until you know their intentions. Their number is 826-661.
Okay. Righteous. Do you know anything about vampires, by the way? Yeah, fear little except for a stake of wood. Okay, fine. Now remember we picked something up from that other Indian shaman in the graveyard? This thing, a fetish with an image of a bat, I have a feeling that's going to come in handy. Let's give the Darkblade a call.
Hello, the Darkblade Club. Johan speaking. What can I help you with?
It's a club. We have... magic fetish.
You say it is an amulet with a bat at its center? My employer might be interested. Would you please drop by the Dark Blade? I'll make sure the gate is left open for you.
Alright. Who is Johan's master, I wonder? We will find out after we shoot these guys. Gotcha. Okay. Let's go take a quick stop at that hotel. Oh, right, I have to talk to you. That's just silly. Yeah. You'd think I'd be able to, like, rent this out for a set period of time. You know, kind of a regular. Couldn't I just have an extended rental, like, a couple weeks? Okay. Well, now that we are all rested up, we're gonna take a little trip down to the Dark Blade Club. Let's see what we can see. I'll just walk you over there. Oh, fine. The other guy I won't be bothered to. This guy, actually, I won't be bothered to shoot. There's that graveyard that we were at before with the Rat Shaman. And here we are, the place that I said that we probably wouldn't want to go to for a while. And here we are outside the Dark Blade. Spooky! Spooky! Dead trees and bats! Alright. Next time on Let's Play Shadowrun with Cookie Cutter Hero, The Dark Blade.